Denny Hamlin, driver of the number 11 Joe Gibbs Racing Toyota. We will get right to questions, so if you have one, we will go up here to Bob.
Bob Hockers, Fox Sports. As a master of analytics, have you analyzed whether you can make it in on points?
Surely you could. You just got to have one or two of the guys up front to sub their toe and you be elite. That'd be the only way.
Speaking of stubbing toes, what is there anything they can do with your picker this week after last week?
No. You ride with the group you got. I think that they're certainly not, they're in a slump for sure. But we got to we got to ride it out and feel like that's the best group that we can put on pit road. And certainly it's not due to talent or anything like that. They've got all the keys that they need for that. They were the best pit crew for the first quarter of this year. But certainly it's just been a lot of different issues on pit road. Pretty much most times we come down, it's been different things. So you can't really pinpoint one, kind of consistent problem that we've had. So you just got to see where it goes.
Let's go to Jordan.
Jordan Bianchi, The Athletic. Broad question, probably no specific answer, but it seems like you guys just don't have the speed right now. And why is that? I mean, that's hard to pinpoint.
I certainly think that we're not leading laps. That definitely is an indicator of speed. We haven't done that over the last, handful of weeks, certainly. I don't know. I think some of it is schedule. We've had, three of these typical ovals that we've, had in the series. Bristol's one of them. We ran top three, all day. And Kansas, every time we got right at the lead, we had a bad pit stop. And then Vegas, obviously, was just, wheels came off on that one. So it's just, and that's been 7 weeks worth. You got the road courses. I'm not going to lead a bunch of laps there and not going to show a ton of speed there. And then the super speedway. So it's just, it just feels like forever. It just, it's certainly not the best time to not be on our A games all around, myself included. So the good news is we've still got a chance even this late in the game.
Looking ahead to Martinsville next week, they're expecting to be a different tire compound. It's supposed to be softer with more wear, that kind of thing. It would seem that would play one great track for you, obviously. It would seem to play your strengths, though, in terms of managing tires and things. Do you look at that as, that's your race?
Yeah, it's certainly is exciting to go there with a tire like we've never seen before, right? Something that's going to be really, really soft, and certainly sounds like tire management, was a thing when they were testing it. The only difference is, certainly you're going to have all those cars out there and it's going to rubber up and then the tire will go away somewhat. But I really applaud Goodyear to go out there and have the nerve to put this tire on in the playoffs. Certainly excited to see how that turns out.
We're going to go to Lee.
Hey, Spencer, SiriusXM, NASCAR Radio, and catchments.com. If you're in a must-win situation next week at Martinsville, given your past history at that track, do you feel like you can close the deal?
I know I can. It's just the will you is the real question, right? And if I knew how the race would play out, I'd do a better job driving. It's just these are variables, and you got 35 other guys out there that got different plans than letting you win. So it's very, very difficult to win these races. We've seen that, but certainly feel like it's a racetrack where if I had to, I'm capable. I just the wheel, I don't know.
We're gonna go up to Holly and then Dustin.
Hi, Denny. Holly Kane with the NASCAR Wire Service. So having said all of this, how do you get the team motivated, back on track, ready to go, positive? What do you kind of handle that? Does Chris do it? How do you guys keep the positive mindset that you're going to need?
Yeah, I think he does a really good job of that. I think that it's truthfully amazing, as bad as the playoffs has gone for us, that we're in the situation we are with three to go, truthfully. It just shows that, you know, in this system, you always got a chance until that last cutoff race is over with. And so it doesn't matter how far back you are in points, you just got to find a way to win. And sometimes it, you know, you can run 10th and win that day. Christopher Bell, it was, I remember lapping him earlier this, you know, in this race last year, and then he comes back and wins the race. So it's, anything can happen, and certainly you're never out of it until they throw the checkered. But Chris does a really good job of pumping the team up, keeping them motivated, and you know, getting the best out of them. And certainly, you know, we all go through these swells where, you know, we're not performing our best, and certainly the timing is not ideal right now. But every week is a new week with them and me, and so certainly I feel optimistic going into this one that, you know, we've done the work in the week to get better, and we're all going to hopefully perform our best.
Dustin
Long, NBC Sports. What do you have to do differently?
That's a broad question. Can you narrow it down?
What do you feel?
There's a lot of things I'd like to change.
Where would you start?
Great question. She said, where do I start? I don't know. I think it starts half hour from now. I mean, I think you treat each individual session and qualifying session and practice session and race just each of them individually. And I think that this sport, momentum is very overrated when it comes to this sport. I think it's very week to week, in my opinion. We gotta perform like we know we're capable of, and we just haven't shown that in quite some time. So where do I start? I make sure that no matter what, I'm giving the team the information they need. I make sure no matter what, I'm putting in the work during the week to get better. I make sure that you know, I execute on the racetrack and give the team a better opportunity to succeed. There's lots of things in my bucket of improvements that I need to get out.
And what if you talk to, you know, to Tyler this week? Obviously, Tyler's known for his aggressiveness, and look at these cars, and this, to be successful, you have to be to a certain level, no doubt about that. How do you talk to him, or what did you talk to him about how he has to approach things now, and what with what happened in last week and moving forward?
Yeah, I certainly, you know, we had those discussions, and certainly feel like, you know, it's a very fine line with Tyler, just simply because, you know, his aggressiveness is what makes him so fast, but sometimes it doesn't get you to the finish. But there's a fine line there, right? If you start trying to pull back and change the way that you've kind of always done things, it's just sometimes you can doubt too much. And certainly in our situations where you got to make split-second decisions, you just don't have time to second-guess and say, you know, you got to just trust your instincts, really, and live with the outcome. And certainly, you know, I kind of stated my opinion on it, is that, you know, it was not much positive things that were going to come out of that situation. Pretty early on, I was probably, I don't know, 50 yards behind it. I saw it coming for quite some time. But yeah, you're in that cocoon, and you just can't see everything all the time. You just try to trust your gut, and I think that he's going to be successful long after I'm gone because of those instincts.
All right, we're going to go to Davey.
He's got one more.
Is because of that, you know, you look at this sport now, and it's hard to really build momentum or build a long streak of success. I remember a few years ago, Byron had like 11 straight top 10s early in the season. Right now, I think, other than Reddick having a stretch of 7 earlier this year, nobody's had more than 5. We look at a guy like Larson, who is so fast, but doesn't have that consistency. Reddick, you know, Ryan's in the back of the room, has had a bunch of top 10s, but he's been wrecked out of a bunch of races. Is it a case of you have to be that aggressive, you have to do that, to be like that with this format, with this way the sport is now, how even it is, because it's hard to build that consistency week after week? So go for it, those opportunities, and be willing to accept hey, maybe I don't get the first, but I'm going to get 35th this week? And
I think you answered your own question. But I think, yes. I think it is hard. Track position is more important than it's ever been, so it's really hard for the fast cars to show they're fast until they get there, and sometimes they never get there. So the field gets mixed up through, you know, ill-timed cautions, things like that, that just, you know, once you get buried, you just never know. Last week at Vegas, there was, you know, I was running 15th at the time, and, you know, there's Ty in the five racing for the lucky dog, and they couldn't go anywhere. I mean, it was just log jammed. And so I think that's it really just puts more of an emphasis on execution of the race and making sure you don't make any mistakes to lose track position now more today than ever. And so that's why it's hard for that to happen week after week after week, especially with the different variation of racetracks. So I just think it's the product of the next gen that it's going to be, you know, somewhat survival in the sense of just, you know, don't take yourself out. And certainly we haven't done a very good job of that, although you would argue that we've gotten away with some finishes that we probably didn't deserve on certain days. So it's very difficult. I mean, all the cars are even. The drivers drive like each other now. It's all just really hard to make passes. And so you certainly need that aggression to separate yourself from the others.
Thank you.